My Last Will by Sir Walter Raleigh. When I am safely laid away, out of work and out of play, sheltered by the kindly ground, from the world of sight and sound, one or two of these I leave will remember me and grieve, thinking how I made them gay by the things I used to say. But the crown of their distress will be my untidiness. What a nuisance then will be all that shall remain of me. Shelves of books I never read, piles of bills undocketed, shaving brushes, razors, strops, bottles that have lost their tops, boxes full of odds and ends, letters from departed friends, faded ties and broken braces tucked away in secret places, baggy trousers, ragged coats, stacks of ancient lecture notes, and that ghostliest of shows, books and shoes in horrid rows. Though they are of cheerful mind, my lovers, whom I leave behind, when they find these in my stead, will be sorry I am dead. They will grieve, but you, my dear, who have never tasted fear, brave companion of my youth, free as air and true as truth, do not let these weary things rob you of your junketings. Burn the papers, sell the books, clean out all the pestered nooks, make a mighty funeral pyre for the corpse of old desire, till there shall remain of it naught but ashes in a pit. And when you have done away all that is of yesterday, may you feel a thrill of pain, master it, and start again. This, at least, you have never done, since you first beheld the sun. If you came upon your own, blind to light and deaf to tone, basking in the great release of unconsciousness and peace, you would never, while you live, shatter what you cannot give. Faithful to the watch you keep, you would never break their sleep. Clouds will sail and winds will blow, as they did an age ago, o'er us who lived in little towns underneath the Berkshire Downs. When at heart you shall be sad, pondering the joys we had, listen and keep very still, if the lowing from the hill or the tolling of a bell do not serve to break the spell. Listen, you may be allowed to hear my laughter from a cloud. Take the good that life can give for the time you have to live. Friends of yours and friends of mine surely will not let you pine. Sons and daughters will not spare more than friendly love and care. If the fates are kind to you, some will say to see you through, and the time will not be long till the silence ends the song. Sleep is God's own gift, and man, snatching all the joys he can, would not dare to give his voice to reverse his Maker's choice. Brief delight, eternal quiet, how change these for endless riot, broken by a single rest? Well you know that sleep is best. We that have been heart to heart fall asleep and drift apart. Will that overwhelming tide reunite us or divide? Whence we come and whither go, none can tell us, but I know passion's self is often marred by a kind of self-regard, and the torture of the cry, you are you and I am I. While we live, the waking sense feeds upon our difference, in our passion and our pride, not united, but allied. We are severed by the sun, and by darkness are made one.